Monitors. Monitors are process synchronization tools. Process synchronization. A monitor type is an ADT abstract data type. So monitor is an abstract data type. Now what is abstract data type? ADT or abstract data type encapsulates private data, with the public functions or methods, public methods, and these public methods operate on this private data. The public methods operate on private data. Class is an example and is an example of ADT. Class is an example of an ADT. As you all know, in class we say that class ABC private, these are the private variables in class, int A, int B, and so on. And then we use the public methods to access these private variables. We say void show. And in this function, we access these private data members of the class. So monitor is just like class. It's an ADT. It contains the shared variables. And it contains the user-defined functions. These are the user-defined functions, which a user defines according to the needs or according to the requirements. So monitor is an ADT which presents a programmer defined, user defined operations, means functions. It contains the user defined functions, just like class contains the user defined functions, that provide the mutual exclusion within the monitor, and the user defined function within the monitor provide the mutual exclusion. The monitor type also contains the declaration of variables. This is declaration of variables, but in monitors these variables are the shared variables. And along with the bodies of the procedures or functions, and also the functions, monitor also contains the functions that operate on the variable. So monitors are the process synchronization tools. They are an abstract data types which contains the shared variables and user-defined functions. And these user-defined functions use these shared variables. And these user-defined functions provide the mutual exclusion within the monitor. Now, this is syntax of the monitor. Monitor is keyword. Monitor name, any name can be here with some rules. Here in class you have the private data members, which are the variables, and in monitor you have shared variables. Here are the shared variables, and these shared variables are used in this function. This is function 1. This function is using this shared variable. This is function 2, procedure 2. This is also using this shared variable, and up to function n. And these all functions are using these shared variables. These are operating on these shared variables, and this is the initialization code. If some variable, shared variable are needed to be initialized, they are initialized here. So a monitor ADT contains the shared variables, then the user defined function. These are the user defined functions. These are user defined functions. Programmer defined function. These functions provide the mutual exclusion. And these shared variables are used in these functions. So the monitor construct ensures that only one process at a time is active within the monitor. So monitor construct ensures that only one process is active within the monitor. Consequently, the programmer doesn't have to code the synchronization constraints explicitly. So programmer doesn't need to program the synchronization constraints. However, the monitor construct as defined so far is not sufficiently powerful for modeling some synchronization schemes. For this purpose, we need to define additional synchronization mechanism. So this monitor code or type is not sufficiently powerful for modeling the synchronization problems. So we need to define some conditional additional synchronization mechanisms with these, with this one monitor construct. These mechanisms are provided by the condition constructs. So to make the monitor construct more powerful, we use condition construct. So now what is condition construct? We'll see it. A programmer who need to write a tailor-made synchronization scheme can define one or more condition variable of type condition. So condition variable has data type return, has type condition. Condition is type, and x and y are two condition variables. So to make the monitors more powerful, make monitor tool, monitors powerful tools for process synchronization, condition variable, condition construct is used with the monitor. Condition construct is used with monitor. So how we can define the condition variables? We can define the condition variables like condition x and y, condition variable 1, condition variable 2. Now the only operation that can be invoked on a condition variable are wait and signal. On condition variable we can invoke two operations, wait and signal. The operation x dot wait means that the process invoking this operation is suspended until another process invokes x dot signal. Means the process that invokes this wait operation with this condition variable is suspended until another operation performs the signal operation with this condition variable. X dot signal operation resumes exactly one suspended process. If no process is suspended, then signal operation has no effects. Now, example of dining philosopher's solution using monitors. Monitor is keyword. This is the name of the monitor and that can be any name according to some rules. DP is the name of the monitor. These are the shared variables. Enumeration, as you all know, this makes the combination. So enumeration is applied on thinking, hungry and eating. These are the states. Three are the different states of the philosophers. Initially, philosophers are thinking, then philosophers may be hungry, and if the chopsticks are available, then the state of the philosopher may be eating. So when enumeration is applied on these three states, they will be like thinking, hungry, eating. And then eating, thinking, hungry, and eating. Next share variable is state. This is an array, and array of that has size of 5 members, array members. And this is self variable of condition type. Self is also an array of 5 data members. And its type is condition. So these are the shared variables. These are the shared variables of the monitor. These are the functions. These are the user defined functions. These functions provide the mutual exclusion. First function is white pick up the chopstick. The second function is white put down. When the philosopher is done with the eating, she will put down the chopstick, and white test whether two chopsticks are available or not. And this is initialization code. As we discussed, that initialization code is used to initialize some of the variables if needed. Here thinking state array is initialized with the thinking. It means initially the state of all 5 philosophers is thinking. Now we come to this function. The first function is void pickup. Int I is passed as parameter. I can be any number ranging from 1 to 5 or 0 to 4. It indicates the philosopher number. If we are talking about third philosopher, or if we are talking, then I is equals to 3. If we are talking about second philosopher wants to eat, then I is equals to 2. If it's first philosopher, then I is equals to 1. So I indicates the philosopher number. Void pickup int I, state of I is hungry. I is equals to 3, then state of third philosopher is equals to hungry. State of I is equals to hungry. Third philosopher state is hungry. Then this test function is called. The control will jump here. Why test int I? So 3 is passed here. If the state of I plus 4 means 3 plus 4, and this is modulus 5, 7, divided by 5 2, it means 2. If the second philosopher stay is not eating, if the second philosopher is not eating, if state of I plus 4 multiplied 5 is not eating, if the state of the second philosopher is second, we got 2 like this. I plus 4 and remainder 5, we get the remainder and remainder is 2. So if the state of the second philosopher is not eating and state of I is equals to hungry, and state of I means the third philosopher is hungry. If the second philosopher is not eating and the third philosopher is hungry, and state of I plus 1 modulus 5, I 3 plus 1 is equals to 3 plus 1 is equals to 4, and if 4 is divided by 5, the remainder is 4. And if 4 and state of 4 is not eating, and if the fourth philosopher is not eating, means here if the second is not eating, second philosopher not eating, this one says if third philosopher is hungry, and this one say if fourth is not eating, so and on these three statements AND operator is applied, it means the three must be true. If the three are true, then what action is taken? The third philosopher state is now eating, means that these statements, state of I is equals to eating, it means the third philosopher start eating. If these three conditions are true, then the third philosopher starts eating, self I dot signal. Now the on this, as we discussed that on condition variables, on two, only two operations can be executed, wait or signal. Now the signal operation is executed with this self variable of condition type. So now the third philosopher will start eating. Now if state of I is equals to not eating, it means if the third philosopher has finished the eating, if the third philosopher finished eating, then self dot I wait, then it will suspend itself. If the third philosopher has finished eating, then it will suspend itself. Now in these two functions we saw that how the philosopher picks the chopsticks to eat. If any philosopher wants to eat, we saw the example of third philosopher. If third philosopher wants to eat, then the state of the third philosopher is hungry, means third philosopher is now hungry. And if the third philosopher is not, when the third philosopher is now hungry, it will pick the chopsticks and to pick the chopstick and to test whether the two chopsticks are available or not, the test function is called. And in test function, it is checked if the right philosopher sitting on the right and philosopher sitting on the left are not eating, then the third philosopher, the philosopher sitting in the middle, will pick up the chopsticks to eat. And when the philosopher pick up the chopsticks to eat and has finished with the eating, then it will suspend itself from the eating process or procedure. Now when the eating is done, how the philosopher will put down the chopsticks? To put down the chopsticks, state of eyes equals to thinking. Now the third philosopher is thinking. Test I plus 4, and this remainder is checked here with the test function, and test I plus 1. Test function is called here again, and test function is called here again. So this is how the dining philosopher problem is solved within the monitors. So students, we discussed various process synchronization techniques. First we discussed the Peterson solution, then we discussed some hardware based solution for the process synchronization. Then we discussed the semaphores. We said semaphores are synchronization tools, and we discussed how semaphores are used to synchronize the access of the processes to the shared data. Then we discussed the monitors, and monitors are robust process synchronization tools. Different libraries or different API libraries different libraries are available to use the monitors. Now if you have any questions or queries regarding the lecture, send me your queries. I'll solve them. Thank you very much.